Hello, and welcome to the next installment of Alex Arts and Crafts.
Alex Arts and Crafts! Making art with friends.
This is episode 439. Today, I will be doing another carving. I am going to try and carve a chess piece, a pawn specifically. I'm going to use a piece of driftwood, one of these that I found the Oregon coast, and while I was there I kind of did a rough try at it. But I want it to look better. So I will try and carve another one. Yeah, there's not much to say. Let's get started.
Step one. Read step one.
Okay.
Step two. Find your material.
Next we have to find the material we're going to use to carve this pawn. So I'm going to try and find some driftwood. This one looks good. Just some wood. So let's use this.
Step three, draw the outline.
So this next step is to draw the outline on the stick. So use the pencil and just draw on the wood. Get the different layers. You can see I drew it on the other side here, the different layers. I use this sketch as an outline because it's a good size, I think. And this will be like the bulb and then that first layer and then the middle and the bottom. Okay. And that's step two. Nope. Oh, that's step three. Draw the outline.
Step four, begin carving.
So we're ready to carve now. I'll show you my tools. I'm going to use this pocket knife. Right. And I'm just going to kind of start by whittling away to get down to good thickness. It's pretty much all I'm going to use. I might use a chisel again. We'll see. Okay. People always ask me, they'll watch this video and they say, "Hey Alec, why are you carving the chess pieces? Like, why?" And I'll tell them, I've always been a fan of chess. I think it's a pretty cool game, all the strategy and planning ahead you have to do. I think I'd really like to learn how to play one day. People always ask me, hey Alec, how do you have the patience to carve anything for all this time? Don't you get bored? And I tell them, no, not really. All this time gives me time to like ponder. My friend was telling me about this investment opportunity. He was like, hey Alec, I've got a way to make you some money. And he explained it to me. Something to do. You give this guy all your favorite chess pieces, and he takes them and works his financial magic, and then gives you back a bunch, like more than what you gave him, and then you're richer. So I thought about it. I didn't actually invest, and a few years later, it turns out my friend lost all of his money, because it was a Ponzi scheme. People always ask me, hey Alec, what's your favorite high altitude Peruvian woolen overgarment? And I say it would probably have to be the poncho.
Step 4, compare to the prototype.
So here's where we're at. I didn't really show you how to get there, but it's pretty straight, it's self-explanatory. So now we're going to kind of compare it to that first one I made, the prototype, I guess. We're getting close. Got some stuff to thin out and get down to the base a little more. So I'll do that next. All right. Guess which hand it's in. No. Is this? Oh, no, it's not this one. What's behind your ear? Oh, no. It was behind your ear. Alright, that's where we're at. They look pretty similar. I mean, it's not gonna be perfect, because it's driftwood, so. The next step is to cut it so it gets shorter.
Step 4, saw off the pawn.
The next step, I guess the last step, is to cut the pawn off and the rest of the wood around that bottom. For that, then we use a saw. It's a little saw. And all you have to do is put it there. You know, 1, 2, 3, and there you have it. It comes right off. And there's my new pawn. It looks very similar to the other one. And now I have two.
Step 5, sand the pawn.
Alright, now I'm gonna sand the pawn. Get a little smoother because it's kind of rough around the edges and doesn't sit quite flat. So I'm gonna use sandpaper again. And just kind of sand it. All right. It's the pawn. Thanks for watching. Please enjoy it. Stay tuned for the next episode. I'm gonna carve a 3-foot-tall, 2-footed dragon. Bye. This is the end.